huh?
What are you doing in my swamp?
Oh, pick me! Oh, pick me! Oh, me! Me! Oh, pick me! Oh, pick me! Oh, me! Me!
This menu's too small.
Special features here.
What's it like being an ogre in a big Hollywood movie?
Being an ogre movie star is not all glamour. I mean, there's a lot of swamp work. There's a lot of toad's eyes you have to eat. There's a press junket, photo shoots, private jets. I met the president last night. It's a lot of stuff, actually.
What's it like being green?
Well, it was Shakespeare, or was it Kermit, who said, "It's not easy being green." I have to disagree. I think it's very easy to be green. It's very easy to be big and green.
Have you been doing your own stunts in the movie?
Yes, I do. I do all my own stunts. I broke every bone in my body. You know, ogres have 15 more bones than humans.
What was it like working with Shrek?
He was kind of a pain in the ass at first. We became really good friends. You know, he's really fun around Halloween, being all green and ugly and stuff.
Did you do all of your own stunts?
No. It's actually a couple of gnomes in the suit and some great special effects.
What are you planning to do next?
I'm working on taking Don Quixote to Broadway as a musical. I'm playing the role of Donkey, of course, and I'm also in discussions with the original Mr. Ed about a remake of The Odd Couple. I'm going to be playing Felix.
Do you have any future plans for your singing career?
Yeah, I'm cutting an album right now under the name Little MC Ass.
Is it true you did all your own stunt work in Shrek?
Yes, I did all the stunts in this film. It was a very exciting experience. It's actually the first time that I've got to swing from a tree. But I did learn a little bit of kung fu after watching Charlie's Angels. I was well impressed with the girls' work in that.
Do you think Shrek is someone you could be attracted to in real life?
Well, of course, he's so cute. I mean, he's green and he does actually eat swamp rats in real life. But he is really just a sensitive, caring, funny guy who just loves to keep everybody laughing. And yes, actually, definitely.
What attracted you to this role?
Really, I was looking for a challenge, frankly. Without giving too much away, I wanted to play someone that ordinary people could relate to. And plus, I got to kick some butt, you know what I'm saying?
How was it working with a donkey?
Donkey is as funny in real life as he is on the screen. Honestly, I mean, he is just sheer animal magnetism. He's fantastic.
What plans do you have coming up in the future?
Actually, Snow White and I were planning on a remake of Thelma and Louise. We've got that in the works right now with DreamWorks, and that should be going into production soon.
Oh!
What?
I could fly!
You can choose to go directly to the funniest and coolest scenes in the movie, starring your favorite characters. See the music video of this hit song from the Shrek soundtrack. The Game Swamp has interactive games and activities for you to play. Check out the trivia game, dress up the gingerbread man, rescue the princess, ask the magic mirror, and the hilarious character morph games.
I'm on my way from misery to happiness to thee. I'm on my way from misery to happiness to thee. And everything that you receive up yonder is what you give to me the day I wonder. I'm on my way.
Well, at least we know where the princess is.
Oh,
wake up!
What?
Are you Princess Fiona?
I am.
What? Wow! Let's do that again!
No! No! No, no, no!
No.
You thought wrong!
Shrek.
Oh, no.
No! No!
You think Shrek is gonna do that?
What is so funny?
That would be none of your beeswax. Try again tomorrow. Who knows? Signs point to yes. Try again tomorrow. Try again tomorrow. Are you kidding? It is decidedly so. Signs point to yes. Are you kidding? Yes. I mean no.
Oh, the farmer in the dale, the farmer in the dale. Hi-ho, the Dario, the farmer in the dale. Row, row, row your boat gently down the stream. Old MacDonald had a farm, E-I-E-I-O. I've been working on the railroad all the live long day. Rock-a-bye, baby, on the treetop. Mary had a little lamb, its fleece was white as snow. Oh, where has my little dog gone? Oh, where can he be? Three blind mice, see how they run. Pop goes the weasel. London Bridge is falling down. Twinkle, twinkle, little star, how I wonder what you are. Rock-a-bye baby on the treetop.
Learn to draw Shrek. You're the artist. Learn to draw Shrek. You're the artist. Create your own Shrek to cut out, color, or just to hang on your wall. You'll need some paper and a pencil, pen, crayon, or marker, and you'll be ready to learn to draw Shrek. Click the Go button below and follow the step-by-step drawing instructions. You'll be an artist in no time. Introduction. Start by drawing the face guidelines. These will help you make sure Shrek's face is the right size. Watch as we create the guidelines for you. You can print these out and use them for your own drawing. Shrek has an oval-shaped face, like an egg. The next guideline is called a vertical ellipse. It will help you decide if Shrek's head should tilt left or right. The solid line is for the front of the head. The dotted line is for the back. A horizontal ellipse will help you decide if the face should look up or down. Here, Shrek is looking up and his head is turned to the right. We'll use a curved line atop the straight line for each eye. Notice that the left eye is larger than the right. Use an oval, the egg shape, for the nose, just below the horizontal line, a curved line for the mouth, and two circles for Shrek's ears. Now, print this guide and follow the next steps to draw Shrek on top of it. Face outline. Begin with the basic face outline. Notice how the lines follow the guidelines. Shrek's face is very round, so we'll start with a large curved line around the bottom. You add a line for the side. Shrek's face is very round, so we'll start with a large curved line around the bottom. Use a smaller curved line for the top of his bald head. Add a line for the side of each cheek and one line for the top of each cheek. Add two straight lines to the right side of his face. And we'll draw two curves for his neck. Eyes. The eyelids will follow the guidelines. Use the horizontal ellipse to help you draw the bottom of the eye. Add pupils to the center of the eye to bring Shrek's eyes to life. How you shape Shrek's eyebrows help determine his emotions. You can give Shrek's brows different shapes and positions for happy or angry expressions. Here, we'll use a high curved shape for the left brow and a lower curved shape for the right brow. Nose. Shrek's round nose is drawn using a curved line for the top and an upside-down smaller curved line for the bottom. Use two more curved lines for each side and two more curved lines for each side to make nostrils. Mouth. Shrek's mouth is huge. It takes up most of his face, so we'll use big lines. Outline the mouth so we can see that it is open. Next, add the borders for Shrek's teeth and lines for the spaces between them. Two curved lines make up the tongue, and fill the rest of the mouth in with black. A few simple lines around the outside of the mouth are drawn for Shrek's lips. Ears. Shrek's ears are his favorite feature. Do you know anyone else with two bugles on the side of his head? Start with his left ear and draw two curved lines to create the stem. Now, draw a half circle that touches the curved lines to create the outer edge of the ear. Add an opposite-facing half circle on the inside to create the ear's opening. Follow these same steps for the right ear. Conclusion. Is your Shrek beautiful? No? Then you've done a great job. Keep practicing and you'll be able to create your own collection of crazy characters. Gingerbread Hangman. What's in a word? The gingerbread man is usually one tough cookie. But this time, he's in real danger. And only you can save him from Lord Farquaad.
Select a letter to fill in the blanks of the hidden word or phrase from the movie and popular fairy tales. If you choose incorrectly, Gingy loses a body part. Be careful. Soup Slam. Waiter, there's an eye in my soup. Chicken noodle and minestrone are for wimps. But even for a mighty ogre like Shrek, dinner can be creepy when it stares back at you. You have 60 seconds to keep your soup from staring you down. Use your mouse to move Shrek's spoon from left to right, and click to sink the eyeballs and other strange objects back into the sludge. The more stuff you knock down, the more points you get.
Oop, Chunky!
Slam. Waiter. Fairy tale lanes. Knock 'em down. When you live alone in an enchanted forest, you've got to make your own fun, like bowling with gnomes. How many can you knock down? Use your mouse to position the bowling eye ball on the lane. Hold down the mouse button to generate speed. Look at the icon on the left of your screen to help you decide the ball's direction. The blue end of the scale angles to the left. Red is to the right. Remember, the speed of the ball affects its path down the lane. Lift your finger from the button to release the ball and watch those gnomes fly.
Donkey! Get out of that. Oh, there's a trophy. Yes.
Hell no.
Well done. Oh, there's a trophy. Oh, there's a trophy. Look at this. Look at this. Nice one.
Hell no.
Ooh, nice one.
Well, that's unusual.
Yes. Yes. Ooh, nice one.
Yeah, ogres do stink.
Donkey. Get out of that. Oh, there's a trophy.
Yeah, ogres do stink.
Bugs and slugs. Make them creep and crawl. Think of it as tic-tac-toe in Shrek's house. Using your mouse, drag your bugs or slugs so that three of them form a line. Up and down, and sideways across the screen. Play against the computer or with your best friend.
An Ogre Night Success. An Ogre Night Success.
Bugs and slugs. Make 'em creep and crawl.
That's a fine how-do-you-do. An ogre knight six.
Bugs and slugs. Charming dragon. Welcome to the dragon's lair. You have fallen head over heels in love with Donkey. It's no surprise he's a little shy. You have a lot of love to give. Can you gain his favor with your charming personality? Use your mouse to move the dragon and catch the falling charms within her glowing heart. You've got to be quick, though, because these charms fall fast. The more you catch, the higher you rate on the love meter. You have 30 seconds per round, 3 rounds altogether. How many can you catch? Charming dragon.
Coloring pages. Lots and lots of color. You'll always have Shrek around. Select your favorite picture here. Print it out, add color, and hang it. You'll need some supplies. 8.5 inch by 11 inch printer paper, markers or crayons. Pick a page. Or a scene. Color a scene. Pick 'em, color 'em, print 'em. Color your favorite Shrek characters and print them out when you're finished. Choose the characters, background, and colors you want. Make tons of different combinations. Color a scene. Pick 'em, color 'em.
Ogre masks. Want to be an ogre? You can be just like Shrek. Choose your favorite ogre mask, then print and cut it out, with a grown-up's help, of course. And if you're using a black and white printer, you can color it too. Put on a show with your friends. Pin the tail on Donkey. Poor Donkey. Donkey always loves to be the center of attention. This time's no different. He's lost his tail and needs your help. Can you put it back where it belongs? You'll need some supplies. Printer, 8.5 inch by 11 inch printer paper, 4 sheets. Crayons or markers for black and white printers. Scissors, ask for help from an adult. Tape, blindfolds, a bandana, sock, or old necktie will do. Instructions. Print out the poster of Donkey and his tail using the links to your right. Next, tape the 4 sheets together to create Donkey and hang the poster on your wall. Now you're ready to play. Blindfold the participants and give each player a paper cutout of Donkey's tail with a piece of tape on the end. Take turns trying to attach the tail to Donkey's behind. Whoever gets closest is the winner.
Fire Donkey! Don't burn the bridge! Princess Fiona is trapped in Dragon's Keep, and only Donkey and Shrek can save her. Shrek's already inside. But can Donkey defend the bridge from Dragon's fiery breath until Shrek returns with Fiona? Dragon's fire will light the bridge on contact. You have to put out the fire by stomping it out. But if you're not fast enough, the bridge could burn away piece by piece. And if the fireballs hit you in midair, Dragon will be eating roast donkey for dinner. How much of the bridge can you save? Use the left and right arrows on your keyboard to move Donkey across the bridge. Hit the space bar while he's walking to make him jump in the direction he's moving. If Donkey's standing still, the space bar makes him stomp out the fires on the bridge.
You know, there's not a lot about that to make you feel good about yourself, I tell you that. I'm totally fierce, you know what I mean? What? You know, there's not a lot about that to make you feel good about yourself, I tell you that.
Fire Donkey Ball. Do some fancy flipping. You've never played pinball like this before. Keep the eyeball bouncing and rack up points by using any of the three sets of slug and bug flippers. Press the left and right arrow keys to control all of the left or right flippers at the same time. You can also press the space bar to give the game a little nudge and push the eyeball out of tight spots or near misses. Careful not to nudge the game too often, though, or you'll set off a tilt. That will send the eyeball right through your flippers. Use the space bar to launch another eyeball whenever your current one drops out of sight. You get three eyeballs each time you play.
Oh, now you, want to stop something? Oh, now you want to stop something? Oh, now you want to stop something?
Lovely.
Oh, now you want to start something?
Donkey. Get.
Pinball.
Play the movie. Yeah, play.
No, not there.